friend Scott Michaels, and he is going to give us a quick tour of the Dearly Departed Artifact Museum.
Let's go.
So this is our most recent acquisition. This is actually a brassiere that belonged to Sharon Tate.
And these are her curlers?
Her curlers and her sewing kit and her little night mask.
And how do you get these things?
Well, actually, these things came indirectly from her sister, Deborah Tate. These were let go fairly recently at Julian's auction house. So that's how we acquired them.
Okay.
We just actually, liberated her eyelashes. I gave her to a friend of mine. I had some from her eyelashes that we gave them to a friend.
Her false eyelashes?
Yeah, no, her real ones. We plucked them out one by one.
No, get out! I like how she had everything was pink.
Yeah, she was very that way, wasn't she?
Yes, very girly.
Very pinky, like Jane Mansfield was.
Yes.
The Pink Palace, of course, on Sunset Boulevard.
Oh, so sad that that's gone.
It is. Oh, it's so sad. But those are the gates. Remember the enormous gates she used to drive
yes.
through? Those are them. And this is the car that she was killed in, which is horrifying,
yeah.
but yet historical, I think.
So it's like gut-wrenching to see it, you know, because you just know what happened, the tragedy that happened.
Yeah.
And
that's
like, the,
yeah, sort of what we do. I mean, it's the Tragical History Tour. It's not all roses and loveliness, but it's still our history.
Mm-hmm.
And although it's a terrible thing to see, it's also an important thing to keep, I think. And we're sort of we're glad that we're entrusted with it. All of these things, actually, we take what we do pretty seriously.
You have Mae West shoes.
Mae West shoes and teeth.
And teeth. Yee. I'm glad those are behind glass.
When I got those, I couldn't put them in my mouth fast enough.
What? No, you did not ever. Oh my God.
Troy won't let me show the pictures. And these are actually pieces of Jane's Pink Palace. The pink. These are big chunks of the house. Her famous heart-shaped swimming pool. Some of the.
I want to go in that pool so bad.
Yeah, that was pretty incredible. What a landmark.
I know. It's so sad that it's gone. It would have been incredible to see that house with the pink shag carpet on the walls.
Oh my God!
That bathroom.
It was most definitely a place.
Yeah.
But yeah, it is so sad that it's gone now. It is.
Did you actually get to tour it before it was?
No. What I do is I hopped the fence when it was being torn down. So there's a picture of me, or that's a picture I took, rather, of me where the heart-shaped pool was.
Yeah.
See that heart-shaped muddy hole in the ground?
Yeah.
So that's where I got that big chunk of the swimming pool from. So, yeah, unfortunately, I saw the house. I was on the grounds, but after the house was long gone.
Yeah.
And you know who Divine was, right? Divine was a large man that played women in movies, most famous for being in the John Waters movie, Pink Flamingos. And he died on Hollywood Boulevard. This is the hotel room door that Divine died behind, which is, you know, it's what we do.
What hotel? Hollywood Regency.
Hollywood Regency. It was just the other side of Fairfax. It was residential for the last sort of 10 years it was around. But Divine, he was most famous for eating dog poop in the movie Pink Flamingos.
Ew.
but also a disco star, and he was doing a part in a show called Married with Children, but he died the day before he did it. He was supposed to be a regular on the show.
Oh, really?
Mm-hmm. And we have some old Los Angeles. You might like this. Let's come back over this way. There's some old Los Angeles stuff over here from some of the old nightclubs. See, it's not all doom and gloom in here, but we do have. I love that picture of the old Playboy Club.
Oh yeah,
and
that's
there's
a
some
cool
of
painting.
From the Playboy Club, and there's an old invitation from Hefner, and we love Playboy. We love Hefner.
Yeah.
We miss Hefner.
Yes. And these are the gates.
The famous gates, yes. Is that, these things have to weigh like 500 pounds each.
Yeah, it seems like it.
They are completely wrought iron.
And how were you able to get these?
Movers. I had to hire movers to move those.
Were they just going to toss them?
How they actually left the property is a mystery to me.
Oh.
but how they ended up here was just a chain of people that had them because they wanted to preserve them, but right. then when you get them, you're like, what do I do with this? They're
yeah.
so enormous. It's like the car. They're so enormous that, that you want to save them, but you have no place for them, and we're the ones that could. So that's how they sort of ended up on our literally in our doorstep, in our shop.
Yeah. Awesome.
And you like the carpenters?
Well, I like a carpenter in particular.
Well, I don't think there's any relation to Karen Carpenter.
No, I don't think so.
But that was the sink from Karen's last home.
Wow, it's a beautiful sink.
It was. Or her home was, anyway.
Well, thank you so much, Bridget, for showing us around.
Thanks for coming back to my museum. It's
yes.
always lovely to see you.
And I love it here.
And thank you for having me on your show.
Of course. All thanks right. for being on it.
We'll see you soon.
Yes.